Hi, this is Clay King from AAA Flood Drying. We have a company where we dry out flooded homes and businesses, and we're located in Westford, Massachusetts. One of the frequent questions I get is, how do you pump out a flooded basement? And I want to show today some of the easier and simpler methods for pumping out a standard small flood in a home or that has a flooded basement. You can do this in a commercial building too. It just depends on how much water you're dealing with. This is a Simer sump pump. It's one of the most common pumps that we use in pumping out flooded basements. I have tried many different models of pumps, but this is the one that I prefer the most. First, I want to explain a little bit about flooded basements and how to get the water out. Normally, when we get to a flooded basement, there's between an inch and 2 or 3 inches of water in a flooded basement. And that doesn't sound like a lot, but it's a tremendous amount of water. It can be hundreds to thousands of gallons, even if it's only a little bit. Most people use a wet vac when they see the water starting to come in. And wet vacs can work well, but it takes a lot of time to suck the water up with a wet vac. It doesn't have a pump. Most of them don't have pumps. And they only hold about 4 or 5 gallons or whatever they hold. And you have to pick this up and carry it. And one of the common problems we arrive at on a flooded home is the homeowner has already made 50 to 100 trips with a wet vac and is finally tired and decided they needed to call somebody, and then they call us. This pump here, the Simer pump, solves that problem. What we do is we install one, two, or as many of these pumps as we need, but most commonly it's only one or two pumps, and we install these pumps. There's a number of reasons why I like the Simer pump. One reason is it's very wide on the bottom, so it's very stable. It doesn't tip over easily, and that's a very good feature, because when you put a hose on it, the pumps tend to tip over. This has a wide base. This pump also has a very wide and very large water jacket that goes around the pump to keep it cool. So only a little bit of water going up into the pump keeps this cool, and that's very important so that it does not overheat. There's also a full screen on the bottom of the pump, so if a little bit of debris starts to plug up the bottom of the pump, this has a large screen so it will keep pumping for quite a while, even if there's some debris that plugs up the pump. It also pumps very close to the floor. The feet are these little tiny things right here, and when I put this down on the table here, you can barely see the crack where the water goes in. So these pumps pump the water the closest to the floor of almost any pump that we know of, and they work very well. Now, sometimes if you have a lot of debris and it plugs around this edge and keeps the water from getting to the screen and to the pump, one way to cheat to make the pump work a little bit better is to just put a screwdriver in like that, and you'll notice there's a larger crack now for the water to get to the pump. This helps a lot when the water is deeper, and then when you get down to a little bit of water, you can get the screwdriver out and it will pump right to the floor. Locating the pump in your basement is critical. Most people put the pump in a convenient spot for plugging the pump in or for getting a hose in or out of the basement. The best way to figure out how to locate this pump is, and it doesn't sound very scientific, but you take your foot and you just tap on the floor and you splash and you find the deepest area in the basement for the water. So if it's a quarter of an inch deeper on one side of the basement than the other, or even a matter of a couple of feet, it's a little deeper by splashing, that's where you want to locate the pump. That's where the water is going to automatically go to on its own. Most people make the mistake of sucking all the water up with the wet vac all over the basement. Instead, if you put this pump in the deepest spot of the basement, you allow the water to run to the pump. The pump pumps the water out. 90% of the basement will probably dry up except for where the water is coming in and where it's going out, and that will be located wherever the pump is located in the deepest spot. So one of the keys to making the efforts that you apply to getting the water out as efficient as possible is to put the pump in the deepest spot of the basement, and that works the best. Now, one of the problems with that is a lot of basements are finished. They'll have carpet and pad, and they're a finished basement. And at this point, if you're dealing with that much water, this is the carpet, this is the pad, and this could be your concrete floor. The water is over the top of the carpet and the pad. You've most likely already lost the carpet and the pad. It is highly unlikely you're going to be able to save the carpet and pad if a lot of it is wet. So you have to make a hard decision quickly, and you have to decide to remove the carpet and pad. Although the first thing you have to do is get as much water out as you possibly can as easily as you can. And you can do that by just taking a utility knife, a sharp one, and cutting a hole right in the carpet and cutting a hole right in the pad. And once you've cut that hole, you can then put your pump right in the hole. Now you can see how thick the pad is, and you can see how thick the carpet is, and so that's 3/4 of an inch to an inch up off of the floor, and that will all be water. So you really need to move the pump down to the floor so that it removes as much water as possible. Then you can continue to take out the carpet and the pad. But if a lot of your basement is flooded, the carpet and the pad are not going to be able to be saved. So you need to make the decision quickly so that you don't get mold. So most of the time, your carpet and your pad are probably going to have to go if you have severe basement flooding. This pump normally comes with a garden hose attachment. And so, and it screws in. This is a very nice system on this pump. It's threaded here on the top. And this is the garden hose attachment. And it's a 3/4 inch garden hose fitting up here. And I think this is 1.5 inches or 1.25 inches plumbing fitting here. But it allows you to change how you pump water. If you only have a small amount of water coming in, you can use a garden hose. And you can put the garden hose on and you can pump the water. Most garden hoses are 5/8 of an inch in diameter on the inside. Some are smaller, they're 1/2 inch diameter. Some are larger, a few more commercial ones are larger, they're 3/4 inch inside diameter. Keep the hose as large as possible and as short as possible. Try not to put a 75-foot long garden hose on your sump pump. If you can afford it, buy a 3/4 inch garden hose. It will pump about twice as much as a 5/8 inch garden hose. It will cost you more money, but it really makes a big difference. Something that allows you to pump a lot more water than a garden hose is to put sump pump hose on this pump, and it will pump 4 to 6 times as much water as a garden hose. And that's really handy, because if you have to remove a lot of water, instead of adding more pumps, all you have to do is put a bigger hose on this pump. So you would take out the smaller fitting here, take out the smaller fitting, and you would put in a larger fitting and screw this in. And you can see the size of the hole. There's quite a difference in the size of the hole. That will allow you to pump a lot more water than just a garden hose. And let me see if I can screw this in. The hose sections come in 20-foot lengths. And I have some here. And this is a 20-foot length of sump pump hose. And it has a flat section on the end that can go onto the fitting. And it just presses onto the fitting. You should get a hose clamp. And you put the hose clamp on the hose, and then put that on the fitting, and then you tighten your hose clamp with a screwdriver. And that's pretty much all you have to do. And this setup will make this pump work 4 to 6 times better than using a 5/8 garden hose. And that can save your basement, or really make pumping out a basement take a lot less time and keep your damages down. If you have to extend one of these hoses, these are 20 feet in length. Commonly, you'll need 2 or 3 of these. They're not very expensive. They're like $10, $20 for a section. You will need a coupling. And this is what a coupling looks like. And this would be 1.25 inch hose coupling, barbed hose coupling. And you can ask the people at the hardware store for them. And what you would do is you would take one section of hose and put your coupling in your hose and put a clamp on it, and then you would put your other hose on, and you would also have a clamp over here. So you have 2 clamps in your coupling, and you can have 40 or 60 feet of hose, and it will pump a lot of water compared to a garden hose. If you want to pump even more water, if you think, you know, you've got a lot of water that you have to remove, another way of increasing the efficiency of the exact same pump, sometimes instead of just using the inch and a quarter hose, if you go to inch and a half hose, it will almost double what you get out of an inch and a quarter hose. And it's about the same cost. It's the same length. You need a little bit bigger fittings. These are inch and a half hose fittings versus inch and a quarter hose fittings. But this hose here won't fit directly on the couplings that come with the pump. So what we do is we take duct tape, and we take some duct tape and we wind it around the end of the fitting, and we make the fitting bigger. Some people say, well, gee, that might leak. Well, you know, we kind of have water all over the floor anyway. So you want to, and you need to do it so that it doesn't plug the hole. I'm doing this kind of fast now to shoot the video. So you don't want to fold this in like I'm doing now. You want to have it back a little bit. But the idea is you want to make this thicker so that it'll fit in here, and then you can put a hose clamp on it. And this larger hose will pump a lot of water. Even with this relatively small pump, this hose will move a lot of water. And this is one of the main ways we pump water out of people's homes. And we have 40 or 50 pumps, and the pump we have the most of are these Simer pumps. And it's, let me see if it has the, it's just basically a 1/6 or 1/4 horsepower submersible utility pump by Simer. It's also called the Classic, and a Geyser 3, all depends. It's the only Coca-Cola blue pump that you're going to find out there. Any other color, it's not the right pump. We've had great success with these little pumps. We can buy and have bought just about any other pump. We really like these, and we have a lot of them. And we commonly, when we do floods for customers, we have two of these on our trucks, on each truck, all the time, because we use them that much and because we really appreciate how well they work that much. And so we always carry two of these pumps on our trucks. And so I, you know, my own little plug for them. They're a great pump. They work really well. And if I can buy any pump that I want, this is the one I want for doing this job. This setup, using this pump, either a garden hose, an inch and a quarter hose, or an inch and a half hose, and getting the pump on the floor in the deepest spot, is the best way to pump your flooded basement out quickly with the least amount of hassle, and stop using the wet vac and stop making the trips in and out of the house. When you're all done and the water's not coming in anymore and there might be a few small puddles, you can go pick them up with a wet vac and it'll save you a tremendous amount of work. Thank you for watching and good luck with your basement flooding problems. Clay King, AAA Flood Drying, Westford, Mass.